Singlish, HDB buildings, the Malayan. Big or small, there are many things that make us uniquely Singaporean and remind us of home. Well, what about hawker centres? Food is probably the number one Singaporean pastime. So, what could be more iconic than a place where people from all walks of life can come together and have a meal? What was it like before we had hawker centres? To make a living, early settlers in Singapore started setting up stores by the roadside. They sold bowls and plates of their homegrown recipes, some of which have been passed down through generations until today. But these stores had no shelter, and business was bad when it rained or when it was too hot. Then, in the 1970s, hawker centres were created when sheltered open-air buildings were built, and licences were given to these hawkers to start their very own hawker stall. With proper stalls and eating areas, and a clean water supply, hawker centres soon became a place where every Singaporean, regardless of race, religion and age, could try different types of cuisines and get to know each other. Over time, hawker centres became something unique to Singapore, a place where Singaporeans could understand each other's cultures better and create common experiences by bonding over food. Now that you know the story of hawker centres, it's time to go out and explore and find out more about this part of Singapore history. Go to your favourite hawker centre, visit your favourite food store with your mission card and try to complete all the missions by recognising the things that make us unique and Singaporean and sharing these things with others. We can do our part to keep Singapore strong and special. So, what are you waiting for?